So today's little trick I want to show you is what we call story jumps in InDesign. And story jumps are designed when you've threaded multiple frames together in a story, like these two, for example. They're threaded together, as we saw in one of the other tips. And you want to actually put a little note on there that says continued on page, whatever, or continued from page, whatever. So in this case, they're threaded together. What I mean by that is they function as a single story. If that frame gets bigger, this one gets smaller, etc., and the text flows accordingly. So we can move that back up to there. But I want a little note down here that says continued on page, and at the moment it's page 5. So I'm going to go in here and drag this out and put a little frame in here and type continued on page. Now the problem with doing this is if I type 5 in there and just move it across to the side, and let's just make this a little bigger so we can see what we're doing a bit easier. There we go. The problem with doing it that way is, if somebody comes along and inserts a page, they maybe decide that they've sold an ad there, or they want to drop a double page spread into the middle or something like that, page 5 can quickly become page 6 or 7 or 60, you know, depending on how many pages they drop in. And I've then got to remember to go through my whole magazine or my whole document and check all of these and look for every one and update the page numbers. And you're kind of thinking about this and you're having to worry about this. And I don't really want to do that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use a slightly different method. I'm going to delete the page 5. So I've got continued on page in a space. And then I'm going to go to the type menu and insert a special character. And it's going to be a marker. And the marker I'm going to use for this one is next page number. So what it will do is it will insert the next page number. Now at the moment it says page 4 and doesn't appear to be working very well. If you look down here, we're on page 4. So that's kind of not working. But the reason is these are not connected. And what I need to do is just drag this up so the two frames touch each other. And if I drag it up so they touch each other, you'll see that's now switched to, say, page 5. Now, if you're not happy with the spacing on there, you can obviously play with that. You can use things like the baseline shift and move it down a little bit and increase that. Oops, clicking the wrong place again. And increase the baseline shift then. That'll push it down a little bit so you've got something more like that. Where this really comes into its own is then when you want to move this one to a new page. So you now decide, actually, we've added an add on page 5 and 6, and we're going to put this down to page 7 down here. When you go back up, you'll notice that's already saying page 7. Or if I go down here and move it across to page 6, it's now saying page 6. So this thing is updating automatically. I don't need to worry about it. I don't need to change it. It's automatically doing that for me. And the reason is I'm using a special character, so it's type, insert special characters, and I'm using a marker for next page number, and I'm then making sure the two boxes are grouped together, or rather are touching, I should say. If you want to, you can select those boxes and you can group them together, and that can be quite handy for when you start moving them around, because if I move that frame over here, the page numbering carries on touching it and moves with it. So grouping can be a useful technique as part of this. The other one you might want to do is another little box over here that says continued from page, and again you wanted to pick up the right page number. So I'll go to the type menu, insert special characters, and this marker is previous page number because it's the page number it came from. And again, it's dropping it in there. It's saying page 6, which obviously isn't the previous page number because that's the page we're on right now. But remember what we did last time? We simply got the black arrow and went down here and touched these two boxes together, and it immediately picks up the page 5 there. So if I now drag these two back over to the left-hand page, it now says 4, for example. And it doesn't matter how many pages are in between. You could have something, you know, on page 3 that's continued on page 60, for example. It really doesn't matter. But it just means you don't have to spend your time worrying about updating these and remembering to go back and check them all. So hopefully that saves people a few little errors on some of the page numbering.